Hello YouTube, welcome to part two of the Honda carb clean. I have a habit of marking stuff. It might wear off, but I'm not going to use much cleaner, but I have a habit of marking stuff where the bowl goes on. This was rather tight. I thought I was going to have to put this up in the vise with my cardboard jaws to get this loose. And of course, this mower is not too many years old. I can look back, put in the description. This mower is only like 3 years old or so. It just started running really bad. I figured maybe something's wrong in the automatic choke because it acted like it was kind of flooding out a little bit. But then it acted like it was missing, like it was running lean and just bogged down, no power to it. Barely got the yard mode last fall. I was mulching leaves. So. Give you a little look at the carburetor. I was kind of studying the throttle here. I don't want to show that yet, but kind of studying the throttle, how it works. There's a little wear mark if you ever took these apart. Kind of confused me, but I got used to it. Normally before it starts, it's going to be wide open, the choke be closed, and the choke opens as the throttle shuts. There, it's opposite what you think. We took the bowl off. Look at that. I did not do anything on this. There was a little bit of dirt around this gasket from being around up in here. I used Awesome Cleaner. I haven't used no carb cleaner yet. So that's it. I'm pretty particular about my gas. I use seafoam additive with a little marble mist oil of my own concoction. And I only use premium fuel. So look at that. Don't have to worry about buying a gasket. That's the only thing I was worried about. I don't know where I'd get one. It might be all over the internet. Of course, it's a Honda. It's probably pretty easy, but we'll pause here. We'll strip down a little bit, and we'll kind of we're looking for a your low speed jet to enlarge it a little bit. I said all carburetors are kind of basic, the same. I've watched many videos of Mr. Pender. Those of you who are subbed to me might be subbed to him. I might put a link to his channel if I can find him, if he worked on a carb similar to this. But I watch all of his mower videos because he has all kinds of unusual carbs, modern, plastic. He just did plastic one a while back. So stay tuned. This is going to be a long rambling video, just me talking about a carburetor. So hang in there. We'll get down there where we can show you where we find what we're looking for. Okay, we'll get you up real close. I'm glad I have screwdrivers that I prize and put away. This Made in USA. This is a mini 4-in-1 screwdriver. Came from a hardware store that was people were retiring. Here's your main jet. Here's your emulsion tube, whatever. And don't get it backwards, but it comes up in here and you'll see the tip sticking through a hole down in here. You see that shadow of that hole? See that hole? Where it sticks through. Don't get it backwards. And how I got that out after I had carefully put this in and wiggled it, not to mess with anything. I had to kind of wiggle it. It wasn't really gummy. I had to kind of wiggle it and then tap on this. The same way the jet, I got it to the very end, and you know, and you got the threads for the bulb. And I took my little needle nose and kind of wobbled it out of there. You know, I don't want to change the hole. But I'm not going to try to remove this. There's a screw here. That is your low speed jet. Right, and your air is going to suck in here this direction. See that little path? Let me get my pointer. You get a little path. Most carburetors are all similar. See that little path going there? It's going to suck air, and it's going to, this is going to regulate how much it sucks. And there ain't nothing underneath here. No. They're a plug. I can't tell if those are Welch plugs or not. Welch plug's this little plug when they factory do stuff. I don't think that's one either. You'll see them on carburetors. Don't take them out unless you have one. I like that. Something was there and then they plugged off the hole and they're done machining. Because you got to make cross holes when you machine. So not getting all that technical stuff. But we do have our micro bits. We do have our little $3 and some pin vise. We're going to find one that is the exact size of this and just run it through and clean it. We're going to use a little air and carburetor cleaner. We got our thing on our air tank over here. Like with your basketball thing to run a little air, 40, 50 pounds of air or whatever. My hand keeps blowing off. It won't take 100. 40, 50 pounds. That's enough. We have really potent carburetor cleaner. It's that Chemtrol or something. So we're not going to be putting a lot of carburetor cleaner through here. So everything looks pretty good. I mean, you hold this up to the light. You can almost see that. Everything looks pretty good. I think we're just going to go for cleaning that and not making that whole beggar down in there on the low speed jet, but just making sure that it's clean. Because you get a mowing, it was a little better, you know, once you had a loader, but the idling, it was running really nasty. So we'll find out when we're done. We may be done with this today, so stay tuned. This is going to get too long on this clean disassemble part. Okay, here's our progress so far. We could not find one to fit this low speed jet. It's so small. So we did have a flashlight shining in here. You stuff your advantage. Had a flashlight shining in here. See that? The things you can think of. I just put a sewing needle down in there, and it would just fit just kind of part way. And I just kind of maybe twisted a little bit. I had it in a pin vise right here. And I didn't want to make it bigger. I just want to make sure it's clean. And then I put a lot of carburetor clear. I got that Chemtrol B12 stuff, and it ate my blue Harbor Freight gloves, because they're not really the gloves to be wearing. It's had to go worse my hands. Might as well show you. Here's where that gets its fuel from. The low speed, it gets its air from right in here. The main jet gets its air from here. Trust me, I'm probably right. I always say that. Don't trust anybody when they say that. Trust me, I know what I'm doing. No, I don't. What we did on here, now some of these bits, they're small. I mean, can you read that? 0.3 millimeter, 0.5. Some of these cheap sets, I swear they're all the same. I found one that just did not want to go in there. Now here's what the thing is. When I started putting it in and I started twisting it, it's like it felt like it was snagging on stuff. Now I'd sprayed it already, okay? But still, it felt like it's kind of snagging on something, so I just kept going in and out. I wouldn't necessarily drag it like that, but I ain't worried about that. But so it could be one size bigger than what it was, whatever point of a millimeter. And it still feels kind of draggy. So even though you could see through it, I say I made it a little bit bigger. Now, I should have did that before and after shot. You know, get it to the camera and see what you think. I think I made a thing just... there's just a little more light comes through there than what it did before. I'm going to blow the camera out. We're going with that. That'll give more fuel. Like I said, it just bogged down and get enough fuel. And of course, it might run crappy at an idle. But that could have been plugged to idle circuit. With just whatever little bit of gunk or something, you know. So, enough yakking. Let's get back together. And it might be part three with this thing running. Because we don't want these videos to be too long. So, show you the pin vise. We'll take a picture of it. It's like $3 and something. I had a video on this. It's so nice. See, you can fit it in your hand and you sit there and spin it. This hex part sits back here. Yeah. And it's just a cheapy $3 up one. I think it was KVC Tools. You just have to remember the video I showed of it. But that's what a pin vise is. Holds in little drill bits and a sewing needle or something. So you get all this added content. See, get all this extra that I don't even charge you for. These are monetized, these videos, but still, like, give me that little bit extra for your money. Okay, stay tuned. I'll be back when it's back together. Probably say goodbye. It just depends how I get going. You may see it run on the end of this video, but if not, it'll be another video. I might post all these in the same day. So quit talking, get back to work. That's all I say. Let's talk more work. See how that holds that? Here, let me move this. Hold on. See how it holds that in there with that little plastic and the flange? Before my pin falls out. I even took a picture of it. And you'll see a mark on the white plastic. You'll see a mark on the white plastic on this side, so you know you got the float in the right way, because there's a little mark from the metal, the aluminum made, like kind of black, tarnished. There you go, that was worth showing. See, that's worth that 30 seconds to see that. Stay tuned. A bonus quick tip, see a wooden dowel, a chainsaw file, or a bolt like that with the head cut off, because you have to fit this up over there and put the hose on, and the gasket's already on there, make sure you put it on the right way. So there's your tip of the day. There's your supper. Don't want to copy Terrell Fixes All. No, I can't compete with him. Stay tuned. This thing might be running. It's alive. I'm doing a happy dance. It's alive. About a minute ago. Don't do this at home and play around with these governors. You don't want to override that governor. The thing in the motor is pushing that. You're trying to force it back. You could break something in. You really should not do that. See how crappy it was, so it started warming up. That funky spring thing up there is part of the automatic choke. I don't understand it, but now it's a little fast right when I first started it. Thanks for watching.